What is up, guys? Welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to jailbreak iOS 9.3.6 or 9.3.5 without any computer, and it's very easy to set up. And this will work on literally any of the 32-bit iOS 9.3.5 or 9.3.6 devices. Make sure to like this video and subscribe because it helps the channel out a ton, and I make lots of videos like this that you definitely don't want to miss. So guys, first thing we're going to do is go into settings. Then we're going to scroll down, go into General and About. And you can see it says I'm on iOS 9.3.6. This will work on both 9.3.5 and 9.3.6. So once you've checked it, go ahead and leave back to the home screen. And let's go into Safari. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to go to the URL that will let us download Phoenix, which is the jailbreak tool. The URL you see on my screen right now is the one you're going to want to go to. It's jailbreaks.app/legacy.html. Once you've got that URL, go ahead and tap Go. And once you're on the screen, you're going to see a big list of jailbreaks. We're going to pick the one that says Phoenix because it's for iOS 9.3.5 and 9.3.6, which is what we are trying to do. So we're going to go ahead and tap that one and then click Install. And you can see on the home screen, it is now installing. And you can see there it is on the home screen now. So if we try to open it right now, it'll say it's an untrusted developer. So what we need to do is we need to go into settings. And then we scroll down into general and scroll all the way down here and you'll see device management. And then you're just going to see a random profile. It could be different from you depending on what day you're doing it. It could be a different name than what I have. So you're going to go ahead and go into that and then click trust. Now you can go out of settings, and Phoenix should work now. But there is something to note about this, that is, Apple does revoke these certificates occasionally, so there might be like a time of the week or something that you cannot use this jailbreak method because Apple revokes it. So most of the time it does work, but if it says unable to install or something like that, then you'll probably need to wait at least a day or two for it to work. But I would say most of the time it works perfectly. So we can go into Phoenix now, and it says we're not jailbroken, so what we're going to do is click Prepare for Jailbreak, then Accept, then ignore this, proceed with Jailbreak, go ahead and begin the installation, and click Use Provided Offsets. Now this may actually take a few tries because this isn't the most stable thing, so if it takes a couple tries for it to jailbreak it, that's totally normal. Just go in and do the same thing if it doesn't jailbreak it the first time. If you see this, just click Done. So once you boot back into the OS, we can go ahead and go back in, and you'll see Cydia is now on your screen. So if we go into Phoenix, if yours didn't properly jailbreak, just go ahead and retry it right here. But mine did work, so I have Cydia on the front screen now. So let's go ahead and go into Cydia. Now your phone is jailbroken, but there is a few other steps I want you to see, just so that your jailbreak is running well, because it is not at all secure to not have an up-to-date jailbreak. You can see over here in sources, just wait for that to be done. So now we can go ahead and return to Cydia. And you'll see these upgrade things. You need to do a complete upgrade. It is not a good idea to do otherwise. So doing a complete upgrade and then click confirm. This will keep your Cydia up to date and just generally in much better working order. Like, there's a lot of bugs with Cydia and a lot of security issues. If you don't update it, it's a very good idea to keep it up to date. And you'll see Cydia just kind of crashes. That's totally normal. If you go back into Cydia, it should be fully up to date. And you can see my screen looks completely normal. So now your phone is completely jailbroken. However, I will show you what happens if you reboot your phone or if your phone dies, what you need to do to get it back in this state. So let me go ahead and turn off the phone. So we can go back into our phone here, and then we can go back into Phoenix. So you can see on here what it says after you reboot, or if your phone dies, it gives you the option to kickstart your jailbreak. If you don't do that, if you try to go into Cydia, it'll just crash. So what we need to do is we need to go back into Phoenix, and we're going to need to kickstart the jailbreak. Just use the provided offsets. And wait for it to reboot. So we can go back into the phone now. And Cydia should be working now, but just to make sure, we can go into Phoenix. And it says it's jailbroken. There's no kickstart option here. So if we go into Cydia, we can see it is working like normal. And your phone is now successfully jailbroken on iOS 9.3.5 or 9.3.6. So guys, thank you so much for watching my video. If this video helped you out, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, because it helps the channel out a ton, and I make lots of videos just like this that you definitely don't want to miss.